Salutations, Celestial Sightseers, I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The full moon of this month, occurring at 1:38 Universal Time on September 9th, is called the Harvest Moon for many Northern Hemisphere cultures. This is the full moon occurring closest to the autumnal equinox. This year, that's the September full moon. In other years, it may occur in the month of October. A few interesting things happen with harvest moons, too. One of them requires a bit of understanding of how the moon moves in the sky and the angle of the ecliptic to appreciate it. As the moon revolves, it moves eastward, on or near the ecliptic, compared to the background stars. And every day, the moon transits the meridian. That's the line in the sky from north to south, bisecting it in half. And it does so 50 minutes later each day. So if the moon transits the meridian at 10 p.m. on a given night, the next night, it transits the meridian around 10:50 p.m. Pretty straightforward stuff, right? So that should apply to moon rises and moon sets of the harvest moon, right? Well, not exactly. At this time of year, our satellite rises just 35 minutes later each night for several nights. It does this because the angle of the ecliptic is so low. See, in winter, the ecliptic has quite the steep angle, jutting up from the horizon. But in the evenings of late summer and early autumn, it is quite shallow in comparison. Note how each successive night sees the moon rise 35 minutes later than the night before. Look for your own local moonrise times with a quick search online, but here near Chicago, the moon rises about 7 p.m. on Monday. By Tuesday, instead of 50 minutes later, it's rising by 7:35. Similarly, on Wednesday, the moon is rising by 8:10 p.m., and on Thursday, it's above the horizon by 8:45. That's why it was a harvest moon, because farmers could see with the moon shining on them after the sun had set. So, how big will it look? Stay right there. And now this week's dark sky fact. Are you a member of your local or national dark sky group? If not, why not? At the very least, join the International Dark Sky Association, or the Campaign for Dark Skies. For a small investment equivalent to one moderately priced Plossel eyepiece, you can help the fight for dark skies. Do it today. These groups work on small budgets, so your membership helps a lot. The harvest moon is larger than any other moon. Okay, let's dispel that myth. The harvest moon is not actually larger than any other full phase. Some people erroneously believe that the harvest moon is larger than other moons, and there's actually a reason or two why they think so. The moon illusion is an optical illusion that causes the eye to think the moon looks larger when it is close to the horizon compared to overhead. There's a few ideas as to why humans perceive this, though researchers have not conclusively linked it to any single one. The two leading ideas are apparent distance and relative size. Now, apparent distance posits the idea that the horizon moon looks larger because it appears farther away than the zenith moon. However, this theory has some problems, one being that only 5% of people report that the moon appears both larger and farther at the horizon, and 90% report that it appears larger and closer. The other leading idea of relative size is well demonstrated with a graphic. Note the circle in the middle of each grouping here. To many people, the circle surrounded by the larger circles appears smaller, and the one surrounded by smaller circles appears larger, yet both are identically sized. But this year, the full harvest moon is very near perigee, that is, its closest point to Earth, and therefore really is very slightly larger than normal, but only very slightly. In fact, whether the moon is high up in the sky or low to the horizon and appears to be larger, you can still take your pinky at arm's length and block the entire moon with it. See, your pinky will cover about 1 degree of sky, while the moon only subtends about a half a degree. But it's still fun to observe the harvest moon and gaze at what appears to be our satellite as a larger than normal apparition on the horizon. If you like this video, please subscribe on YouTube or like Eyes on the Sky on Facebook. Thanks for watching, and please consider sharing this video so we can educate about light pollution issues and what to see at night. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.